गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन सीरीज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री लेक्चर्स इन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 12th. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अ टॉपिक ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर 10, हैलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स. हाउ विल यू डिफाइन हैलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स? इन सिंपल वर्ड्स, हैलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स कैन बी डिफाइंड एज the replacement of one or more hydrogen atoms of aliphatic or aromatic hydrocarbons by one or more halogen atoms like fluorine, which is an halogen, chlorine, bromine and iodine are called halogen derivatives of hydrocarbons. Halogen derivatives are further classified as follows in the two ways. First, on the basis of hydrocarbon skeleton. The halogen derivatives are classified as haloalkanes, haloalkenes, haloalkynes and haloarenes. Following are the example, the first, that is, I would say CH3CH2X, where CH3CH2 is the ethyl and X is any halogen, where it can be a fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So it is having a single bond, and that's why it is known as haloalkane. The second one, which is having a double bond, which is an alkene, and since there are two carbon atoms, between the two carbon atoms there is a double bond, it is haloalkene, and there is an halogen, and that's why it is known as haloalkene. The third one, it belongs to the family of alkynes, where there is a triple bond between the two carbon atom and there is an halogen on one carbon atom, and that's why it is known as haloalkynes. And the last one, which is an aromatic compound, benzene, where there is a halogen on one of the carbon atoms of the benzene substituting one of the hydrogen, and that's why it is known as haloarenes. So on the basis of the carbon skeleton, this is the classification of halogen derivatives of alkanes. Second one, on the basis of the number of the halogen atoms, means there could be one halogen, two halogen, three or four. This is the classification as follows, that is, on the basis of the number of the halogen atoms. If there is one halogen atom, we call it as monohalogen derivatives. They contain only one halogen atoms. Example of monohalogen derivative is CH3CH2X, where is an open system where we could say ethyl halide, where X could be any halogen in general. And also in case of an benzene ring, there could be one of the hydrogen of the benzene is substituted by an halogen, and then since there is only one halogen substituting one of the hydrogens of the benzene, we call it as monohaloarenes. The main difference between the two is one is monohalogen alkanes and one is monohalogen arenes. One is an open system and the other is a closed system. The second one is dihalogen derivatives. They contain two halogen atoms. One is CH3CHX, where there are two halogen atoms on ethane and also on the same carbon atom. It could be a geminal dihalide or a vicinal dihalide. And the second structure says CH2CH2, where there is X and X. So there are two halogen atoms on the adjacent carbon atom. We call it as vicinal dihalide. Then in an aromatic ring, there are two halogen atoms on the adjacent ring, the adjacent carbon atom of a benzene ring. And that's why we call it as dihalogen derivatives. The third one is trihalogen derivatives. They contain three halogen atoms. If you see the open system, on each carbon atom there is a halogen, positively satisfying the valency of carbon and hydrogen. Carbon has the valency of 4 and hydrogen the valency as 1. So there are three halogen atoms, and that's why it is called as trihalogen derivatives. In case of the first, that is CH2CH2, where there are on each carbon atom there is a halogen. And in the closed system, there are three halogen atoms on each carbon atom. There are three halogen atoms on three carbon atoms, and that's where it is called as trihalogen derivatives. The fourth one is tetra. Tetra means four. They contain four halogen atoms. For examples, tetrahaloalkanes. Then for example again is carbon tetrachloride. We also call it as tetrachloromethane. So these are the four different halogen atoms on the basis on number of carbon atom, number of halogen atoms, which are defined as monohalogen, dihalogen, trihalogen and tetrahalogen derivatives of alkanes. Classification of monohalogen derivatives. Mono means one halogen on carbon atom. On the basis of the position of the halogen atoms and the type of hybridization of carbon to which halogen is attached. Alkylalides or haloalkanes, where a halogen atom bonded to sp3 carbon atom. It may be primary carbon atom, secondary carbon atom or a tertiary carbon atom, where we call it as Rx. R is an alkyl group, X is a halide. For example, R could be CH3 and X could be Cl, so methyl chloride. In the primary carbon atom, if you see RCH2X, where X is attached to CH2, and this CH2, which we call it as C as halogen carbon atom, is attached to one other carbon atom, that is R. It is called as primary alkyl halide. The secondary alkyl halide is that alkyl halide where the halogen carbon atom, that is CH, in particular C, is attached to two other carbon atoms. For example, it is R and R. So this halogen carbon atom, which is attached to two other carbon atoms, is called as secondary alkyl halide. The third one is RC, where CX is a halogen carbon atom, and this halogen carbon atom is attached by three different alkyl groups or a same alkyl groups, RRR. And since they are attached, this halogen carbon atom is attached by three alkyl groups, it is called as tertiary alkyl halides. The second part is allylic halides. What is allylic halides? Allylic halide, in simple term, there is one double bond, maybe in an open system or a closed system, where X halogen atom is bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon atom next to carbon-carbon double bond. If you see here in the open system, CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2X, where XCH2, that's a halogen carbon atom, is attached to a carbon atom which is attached to a double bond. In the similarly, in a closed system, X, there is a CH and a double bond and a CH, and CH2, 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 there are there. In that also, there is a halogen carbon atom which is attached to the next two carbon-carbon double bond. For example, 3-chloro-prop-1-in, where 3-chloro is the IUPAC name of the above example, that is CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2Cl. There should be a bond between CH2Cl, and chlorine is attached to the third carbon atom, as the basic numbering starts from left hand side, that is CH2-1 double bond CH2 CH2-3. So the third carbon atom, chlorine, is attached, and that's where the IUPAC name is 3-chloro-prop-1-in. Similarly, here also the numbering comes to the third carbon atom for the chlorine, because the priority is given to the double bond, and that's why it is 3-chloro-cyclohexene. The next is benzylic halide. Benzylic halide is a halide which is attached to a benzene molecule or benzene ring, where X, that is an halogen atom, bonded to sp3 carbon atom, which is further bonded to aromatic rings. If you see, the primary benzylic halide is CH2X, where the halogen is attached to the side chain of the benzene ring. Secondary, the similarly, where the secondary halogen or secondary carbon atom is attached to the side chain, where one of the hydrogen is substituted by an alkyl group. And tertiary, where the side chain is attached by two alkyl groups, and that's why halogen carbon atom is attached by two alkyl groups plus there is a benzene ring, and that's why it is known as tertiary benzylic halide. Vinylic halide, where halogen atom bonded to sp2 hybridized carbon atom of an aliphatic chain, that is carbon to carbon double bond, that is nothing but haloalkene. Now haloalkene means CH2 double bond CH single bond X, where the halogen is attached to a alkene, that is we call it as vinylic halide. Similarly with the closed system also, it is directly attached to the carbon atom where it is attached followed by a double bond. Haloalkyne. Haloalkynes are nothing but a halogen attached to a alkyne, means a triple bond, where halogen atom bonded to sp hybridized carbon atom. We can see the example CH triple bond C single bond X, where X halogen is attached directly to the carbon atom to which carbon is bonded to a triple bond. Aryl halides or haloarenes, this halogen atoms bonded to sp hybridized carbon atom of aromatic ring, where the halogen is directly attached to the benzene ring, where in this first case it is directly attached to the benzene ring, and secondly it is methyl halide, we also call it toluene, that is chlorotoluene, or CH3 benzene ring is there and X, so we call it as chlorotoluene if X is halogen. Nomenclature of halogen derivatives. For any compound in the universe, we need to have a common nomenclature, a nomenclature which is universally accepted. There are two types of nomenclature. One is a common nomenclature and the other is a IUPAC nomenclature, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, that is nomenclature. The first is a common nomenclature. First, write the name of the alkyl group. Then, write the name of the halide. For example, if the halide is fluoride, fluorine, we write fluoride. Chlorine, chloride. Bromine, bromide. And iodine, iodide. Use prefix N. N for normal. Iso for branching. Secondary, tertiary. There is again a branching. Neo branching at both the sides for higher alkyl halides. This is a common name. For example, if I take CH3Cl. So CH3Cl is an ethyl. CH3Cl is a methyl, and we call it as methyl chloride. The second example, if I take CH3CH2Br. So we write ethyl bromide. So this is a common name. So you take a common name, you name the alkyl group and followed by a halide. The second is IUPAC name. For the IUPAC names, we call it as haloalkane. We need to follow certain rules. First is find out the position of the halogen atom. Then you name the of the halogen atom. Then position of any other group. And then name of the other group and name of the parent name. Aryl halides are named as haloarenes. For dihaloarenes, using prefix, you use OMP, ortho, meta, para, in common name. But in IUPAC name, we use number system, either 1-2 or 1-3 or 1-4 respectively, because there has to be minimum 2 substituents on a benzene ring. Now, what are the rules of the IUPAC nomenclature? You will select the longest continuous chain having halogen number, halogen carbon atom, or we can say, we select the longest continuous chain having halogen atom. Then number the selected chain in such a way that the halogen gets the lowest possible number or a position. The third is, if there are same substituent, use terms like di, tri or tetra. For same substituents, use terms like tri. And the last is, arrange the substituents in alphabetical order. Let us come to some common examples as follows in the following chart. If you see here, it is CH2Cl2. Now here there are two halogen atoms and two hydrogen atoms, right? But there is only one common name, that the base name is methane here, because since there are only one carbon atom, that is CH2, and there are two halogen elements, two hydrogens of methane have been substituted by two chlorine. So then the common name is methylene chloride. Methylene chloride. The second IUPAC name for the same compound is dichloromethane. Why dichloromethane? Because there are two chlorines, we call it as dichloromethane. Second example, if you see CH3, CH2, Br. So the base name is ethane here, where one of the hydrogen is substituted bromine, and that's why we call it as ethyl bromide. And the base name becomes bromoethane. Bromoethane. The third is CH3CH, where to this CH, Cl is a substituent, branching is there, bond is there, and again CH3 is there. So here it is one site, and that's why we called it as, there are three carbon atoms, and that's why we called it as propyl. But since there is a branching, we call it as isopropyl chloride. In IUPAC nomenclature, we number it either from left hand side or right hand side. If you number from left hand side, the CH3 becomes 1, the second CH becomes 2 carbon, and the third is CH3. So that's why it is 2-chloropropane. So 2 is a position of the carbon atom to which the chlorine is attached, and propane, since there are 3 carbon atoms, so the base name becomes propane. The next is CH3-2, twice CH, means to this CH, there are 2 substituents. One is maybe on the straight line, CH3, and one may be branch. Next is CH, and single bond, CH2Br. So here also there is a substituent, and since there is a branching, we call it as iso. And since there is a branching, we call it iso one side. And since there are 4 carbon atoms, we say isobutyl. And bromine is there, halogen, and that's why we call it as isobutyl bromide. If you see the IUPAC nomenclature, we number it not from the left but from the right, because the halogen has the first priority, and we number CH2 as 1 carbon, CH as 2 carbon, CH3 as 3rd carbon, and there is branching on the CH, maybe up or down, which is a methyl. So we call it as 1-bromo-2-methyl-propane. So base name is propane. The next is CH3 thrice, tertiary carbon atom, and a bromine. So the valency of this carbon, single carbon, is satisfied by 1-bromine and 3 methyl groups. And that's why there are 4 carbon atoms, and we call it as butyl. And since that carbon is tertiary, we call it as tertiary butyl, followed by the halogen bromine. The IUPAC name of this compound would be 2-bromo-2-methyl propane. 2-bromo because it is attached to the second carbon atom, and 2-methyl propane, we are selecting the longest chain, that is propane. The next is CH3 thrice C, CH2Cl. It is neopentyl chloride. Neo means both the side branching. Pentyl means there are 5 carbon atoms, and since there is a halogen chlorine, we call it chloride. The IUPAC name of this would be 1-chloro-2-2-dimethylpropane. 1-chloro because chlorine is attached to the first carbon atom, 2-2-dimethyl because to this carbon atom C, second carbon atom, there are 2 methyl groups, one up and one down, and followed by one more carbon atom, that is CH3, and that's why it is known as 1-chloro-2-2-dimethylpropane. The next is vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride means a halogen attached to, very next is a double bond, and that's why it is called as CH2 double bond CHCl, that is vinyl chloride. We called it as 1-chloroethene, since the halogen is attached to CH, that is carbon, and that's why we called it as 1-chloroethene. The next is allyl bromide. Allyl bromide means a bromine which is attached to a carbon, and that carbon is attached to adjacent carbon which is having a double bond, and that's why we call this allyl bromide. And in IUPAC nomenclature it is 3-bromo, because The priority here in this case is gone to a double bond, and that's why numbering starts from left, 1, 2, 3, and bromine carbon gets the third position, and that's why we call it as 3-bromopropene. Then is a alkyl group, alkynes, where there is a triple bond, and here a chlorine is attached to a carbon atom, and this carbon atom is connected to the another carbon atom by a triple bond, and that's why we call it as an acetylene molecule, and that's why we call it as chloroacetylene. Since chlorine is attached to acetylene, we call it as chloroacetylene. We also in IUPAC nomenclature we call it as chloroethyne, YNE, that is an alkyne. Then is aromatic closed system benzyl iodide, where benzyl iodide means C6H5CH2I, where C6H6 is connected to a methyl iodide, and that's why we call it as benzyl iodide. We call it as iodophenyl methane. The next is para iodotoluene. In this case, toluene is attached in a para position with iodine, and that's why we call it as para iodotoluene. It is common nomenclature. We use the terms ortho, meta, para in a common nomenclature. But in IUPAC, we give the priority to iodine as 1 because it belongs to halogen family. And that's why it is 1-iodo-4-methyl-benzene or 4-iodo-toluene. The last example in this lecture we would see, that is meta-dichlorobenzene, where chlorine is with the meta position with the chlorobenzene, and that's why we call it as meta dichlorobenzene. But in IUPAC we call it as 1,3-dichlorobenzene.